Alright, welcome to another episode. I'm in a two-man queue trying to win some M10 booster packs so I can play in Thursday Night Magic. This time I'll keep because I have a second turn Pride Mate. I can pump him, have Doomblade mana up. Okay, so Elspeth is also a nice addition for fourth turn. So he's playing Plains. Let's see. If it's a blue-white, I'm gonna be less than happy. Not too much of a fan at this point. Yep, he's blue-white, so I can expect some. Oh, blue-white allies? It's gonna make Doomblade on second turn a lot better. Oh, Okay. I do always have to yield with Pride Mate. Doomblade now, because it's not like there's much else going on. Like, waiting for sorcery speed really wasn't gonna. Waiting for it to cast Doomblade at instant speed wasn't really gonna do me much good. Because he could always just block. Like, if he sacrifices it, fine, but then I just lose 3 damage, and I have other removal. Like, if you play something that I actually have to worry about. Okay. That's not too scary. Okay, so. Executioner Capsule comes out. If he tries any funny blocks, then I can just kill one. And there we go. I don't really lose anything by holding back Elspeth at this point. Am I just better off? I'm better off just using the capsule at this point. Like, he's gonna get 2 damage in on me, and that's fine. And next turn, I'm going to play Elspeth with. So end of turn, I really just have to get rid of his creatures. He's playing allies. It's the general concept of play more creatures, play more creatures. I'm playing the Sanctum now because if I draw Titan, I'll really regret not playing it at this point. I'm gonna create a token because I don't want him like to have extra guys and beating on Elspeth. And after like one token, I can pretty much just put a Ajani's Pride Mate into the air. Like, because then it puts him on a 2-turn clock. If I hadn't done it that way, then Talus Paladin kind of changes the math a bit. And by a bit I mean a whole lot. Because every ally is going to give him some life now. I kind of have to block. I mean, if Elspeth takes that now, then I'm in worse shape the next couple turns. If I let her take it, though, shit, I can make another token. Play the Gargoyle Castle, and if anything, have a blocker. I'd rather let her take the three now and have more blockers for later. This is one of those moments where it's like, let's see what he's playing. The red splat, the red is kind of throwing me off here. Oh, he's gonna have another Talus Paladin. At least lifelink doesn't stack anymore. So I'm gonna have to crack Gargoyle Castle and kill one of the Talus Paladin. Let's see what's gonna happen here. Okay. Okay, I can 5 power in one direction. I can chump 4. I can chump chump. I basically. I'm being attacked by both of them, which actually, okay, if he has the Evangel, that makes things a lot worse for me later, but, okay, let's see. I'm gonna have to, like, make the token and kill one of them. So question is, instead of using the tokens, I'm just gonna use the Pride Mate and the Gargoyle token. It just makes things a little easier on me. He's pretty slow here. So now I know he's playing lightning bolts. Makes things pretty much just hoping for sun tanning at this point. That's like, I don't really have any outs other than. Then Sun Titan. Also have to make some tokens for some chump blocking and hoping he doesn't draw more. Okay, that screws me up. Even if I draw Sun Titan, what do I get back? Sun Titan won't even really be able to block. Swinging in for 13 now. If I'm playing towards my outs, I have to take this shot now and have a blocker next turn. So I lose. Wasn't even paying attention to him attacking Elspeth, but there was nothing I could do at that point. Okay, so putting in more removal. Putting in more removal. Also, Fizzing is good in that matchup. Actually, path isn't as good considering the fact that it gives them more mana.